Today I'm going to show you a schedule of a different kind. Normally when I'm making schedules, they have a preset. They're 8 hours, 10 hours, 12 hours, or whatever for the whole week, or however it works. This one is a little bit different. This is where they have random hours in random locations. And the gentleman I was talking to was looking for something that would be able to track that and keep a running total of the hours that they have, so that he doesn't overly tax somebody and then leave somebody with no hours at all. So what we're going to do is I'll show you how it works. So let's go click on this cell, and that's going to be my active cell, and then I'm going to go enter hours. Okay, so we have the start time. Let's do a drop down, and we have, let's start at 8 o'clock, and then we're going to go to 3 o'clock in the afternoon, or I'm sorry, 1 o'clock in the afternoon. And then these are just cities in the province I live in. And so let's go that he's going to be working in Calgary. Okay, and so now when we go enter shifts, you notice that the drop-down times have turned into decimal places, and this is the decimal part of an hour. But they, when you press the enter shifts, they will turn back to hours. And so there we go. He's working 8 o'clock to 1 o'clock, and then it goes on his schedule, 8 to 1. He's working in Calgary, and he has a total of 5 hours that day. Okay, so then let's go... let's say that he works on Wednesday as well. So we click in this cell, we go enter hours. And so let's say he gets to sleep in a little bit. Let's say he's going to at 10 o'clock and he's going to, let's say 6 o'clock. And he's still in Calgary. And so we enter the shift. The hours have changed back to 10 and 6 that I've selected. We close this down, and the hours have been the total. So now we know that this guy has worked 13 hours. So we know if he'd worked 35 hours, then we'd only be giving him another shift of 5 hours, but he's still got quite a bit to go. So let's look at how I did this. First of all, I created a user form. And so let's go to the developer tab and let's go to the user form. So these are combo boxes, and combo boxes on your menu are these ones here. And the problem is why the numbers turn into decimals is combo boxes are designed for you to do text in them. And the text, it has a problem with numbers in it, so we have to do a few things. Now, to get these numbers to go in there, what I've done is on the properties box here, you scroll down and so you get to row text, row source, and I have S time. So let's go back to my sheet here, and let's go to my sheet 2. And what we're going to do is I'm going to select the name range S time. And there I have 8 o'clock to 7:30. So it goes all the way around. And so that is where it's getting the values from here for the dropdown. Okay, the same thing works for the end time. It's a combo box, and it's getting its hours from S time as well. Now for the location, one more time, it's a combo box. And it's quite happy because I have text in there instead of a number. And so we go back to our sheet, and then we go to the property, and there's all our names that we have in here, the cities in Alberta. And so that's where that comes from. So now let's go and let's look at what the code is. So I'm going to right click and I'm going to go view code. So what it's doing is saying, then I've declared start as a date, even though it's a time, you put it in as a date or else you're not going to get anything close to it. Start time as a date, end time as a date, difference as a double, location as a string, new rows, and total hours as a double. So this is how I convert. How I convert the numbers from a decimal place back to the hours. So I've done it for combo box one and combo box two. Now I say wherever your cell is, that's the active cell. And then that's the new row is the row that you're on is the active cell. And so the start equals your combo box one, the end equals your combo box two, and the location is your combo box three. Active cell value equals start and a dash and end. So now we're going to go active cell offset. So we're going to go down one below the times that we have entered in there. And I'm going to put in the location. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to calculate the difference between start and end. Even though we've told it formatted it to AM and PM, it's still coming up as a decimal. And so to get a true value, an hourly value here, I'm multiplying it times 24. And so that will give me the number of hours. Okay, so total hours is the active cell, new row, which is a row that we're on, plus one. So we go down one, so it's below their name. And then the first column, and we're selecting that. And then active cell value equals active cell value plus the difference. So the difference is what you've calculated here. And and that's the active cell value. And then we go end sub. I will, of course, include this in the description of my video. So that is how, let's go back to this one. That is how you keep a running total of the hours of people in random locations. Please subscribe.